Welcome to another Mr. Hill's Math Minutes video. The video that will help you help your students find success in fifth grade mathematics. And today we're going to be talking about the misery of memorization of multiplication facts. But we're going to look to an alternative way to practice those facts. Something you can do at home quickly with a piece of paper and a pencil. We're going to practice dot in the box. Let's take a look at exactly how a dot in the box works. For this activity, we'll need a piece of paper and something to write with. A dot in the box. First of all, we have to draw a box. Actually, it's a square, but dot in the square. Dots in the square. Anyway, what we do is we have to draw three dots in the box. Now from there, we're going to want to know what 1 times 3 is. That's pretty simple because it's 1, 2, 3. And we'll just write our 3 right below the box. So 1 times 3 is 3. And you could actually write 1 times 3 equals 3 on that side. Now from here, we're going to do 2 times 3. And to find that one out, we take our 3. And then we count the dots in the box. So we go 3. 4, 5, 6. And we write our 6 down. So 2 times 3 is 6. And we'll continue that way. So the next one we have 3 times 3 equals. Now it's really important that you have your students say the number so they don't get off count. So we're at 6, 7, 8, 9. And we'll continue that way all the way through 12s. So we take our product and we count that product plus the 3 in the box. And that's going to give us our next product of the two factors. So let's take a look at 7s. So we're going to draw our box. And we have 7 dots. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Need to keep those pretty orderly too. So the first one is 1 times 7. Just count the dots. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Have your student write down 2 times 7. We're at 7. Say 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Next one, 3 times 7. Again, have your student say 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. Next one, 4 times 7. I think you guys are getting the hang of this now. 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28. We're up to 5 times 7. We're at 28. Say 28. 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35. Now, if you have your student do a dot in the box 3 times a week for 3 weeks, chances are they're going to know their 7s, their 8s, and even if they don't know them for sure, they can always write a dot in the box on their paper, on their test, on a scratch piece of paper, and bring those answers in with them. It doesn't have to be memorized. All you got to know is dot in the box. Till next time, see you later.